You're watching Grizzly News Network.
Good morning, Grizzlies. I'm Riley S.
And I'm Jordan Baker. Here's what's happening in your world in 30 seconds. It's Hispanic Heritage Month, and later in the show, GNN takes a look at how one of our own is doing her part to celebrate her culture through sisterhood.
Plus, how the Spirit Squads and Third Quarter Band is teaming up with area elementary and middle schools to help those in need.
And the Grizzly football team is looking to secure their first win of the season tonight against Little Rock Central. All these things and more straight ahead on Grizzly News Network.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power.
What do you find interesting about Hispanic culture?
Well, I think everything, our language, our food, our customs, our celebrations, festivities, everything that the Hispanic culture, and more importantly, the influence that Hispanic have here in the United States.
Personally, I love the food. I'm always down for a pupusa or for a tamale, and I also just really appreciate the language because it's a lot easier to learn than you think it is, and it's just really interesting.
Interesting, I think it's super pretty, and I just love, like, even if I don't understand, I love listening to it.
Here at Northside High School, we are celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month, and for many, that may look like highlighting the accomplishments and history of Latinos in the United States.
This morning, we shine the spotlight on one of Northside's own, Ms. Jana Grina, a family and consumer science teacher who celebrates her culture through the Sisterhood of Greek Life.
That's right. Ms. Grana is a founding member of the Latin sorority, Hermandad de Sigma Iota, on the University of Central Arkansas campus. Grizzly News Network sat down with Grana. Here's a little bit of her history.
I joined Hermandad de Sigma Iota Alpha Incorporada because I wanted a sense of sisterhood and to help my Latino community around Arkansas and just anywhere where I'm needed.
Next week, GNN reporter Shyla Gonzalez will wrap up this story as one of our Hispanic Heritage Spotlight stories. In other Grizzly news, it's homecoming and the halls have been flooded with school spirit. Tonight, the Grizzlies hit the field against the Little Rock Central Tigers, but more on that in sports. The past few weeks, we have highlighted the homecoming court, starting with the seniors, juniors, sophomores, and this week, we too congratulate the freshmen. Mates, let's give a shout out to Jana Hall,
Maggie Jones,
and Sophie Monchamp. So when you see them in the halls, give them a big congratulations.
Don't forget to end homecoming week celebrations. We will top off the week with highly anticipated homecoming dance. It will take place this Saturday from 8:11 p.m. in the field house. There will be music and snacks available. If you haven't gotten your tickets yet, you can purchase them at the door for $10.
Hey, what's up, Fort Smith Public Schools? I am McKenna Borland.
And I'm Ryder Baker, and Northside Student Council has a challenge for you.
That's right, we challenge you to win a Northside pep rally for your school.
That means Northside athletes, cheer, dance, third quarter band, games, and great fun coming to your school.
So how do you win? From October 30th to November 10th, we challenge you to bring canned food items. If your school brings the most, you win a pep rally.
Take a look at what we will bring to the school that wins.
Thank you.
In addition to a pep rally, we want to honor you and your school by you getting in free to a Northside basketball game. More details to come about this.
So make sure you bring as many canned food items as possible from October 30th through November 10th. Go Bears!
Administration wants to remind students that parking in the band parking lot is still not to be allowed. This is the parking lot behind the stadium. The band uses this lot to practice. Administration apologizes for the inconvenience.
Also, please refrain from parking in the designated senior parking spots if you haven't purchased them. The first three rows have already been claimed. You can find a picture of the available spots in your Schoology announcements. Senior parking spots are still available for purchase, though. They cost $40, and you can buy one from Ms. Meeker's room, 218. Remember, this money goes towards our senior prom.
Now, let's talk about punctuality. It's crucial to arrive on time for class. Every tardy and absent counts. After school detention and SDC will be enforced. So make sure you're present and on time. You don't want to miss out on your well-deserved break.
Speaking of attendance, if you are 16 years old or will be by September 1st and haven't received your meningitis shot, please do so. The deadline is October 1st. If you fail to do so, it will result in being sent home from school with an unexcused absence. Please contact the nurse's office with any questions.
Next, this is for all 10th, 11th, and 12th graders. If you have a GPA of 3.5 or higher, you are eligible to apply for the National Honor Society. The list will be posted outside Ms. Brinkley's room, SE10, along with your English teacher. You can also find a link in Schoology announcements. Applications can be picked up in SE10 before school, after school, or during lunch. The deadline is October 6th. And late applications will not be accepted.
Ew! We have an important update regarding the senior sunrise. The event has been rescheduled to October 6th. Please mark your calendars accordingly and join us on the new date.
Attention, all students. This school year, administration is cracking down on bad student behavior. To have more student accountability and responsibility for the rules on campus, our GNN reporter, Shyla Gonzalez, talks with school resource officer, Officer Bray, with the story.
New jurisdiction has been put into place here at Northside High School, called citations. Citations were put into place by administration in hopes that students will stop juvenile behavior. And student conversations proved to have many opinions on the matter.
Okay, so we have different citations. Obviously, the main known one is going to be a citation for possession of any type of drugs, narcotics here on school grounds.
Officer Bray says that officers will write a citation without actually arresting students and transporting them to juvenile detention.
But there's a number on that citation that your parents must call within the 48 hours. If not, a warrant can be issued for you. The citation basically puts you in the court system. You call the court, they give you an intake date, and you go to court. And from there, the courts decide what the punishment can be for you.
With these new citations, there are also tickets for truancy, speeding, and not having a parking permit here on campus. But students say the citations are excessive and shouldn't be arrested for small activities.
Dress for Success is entirely objective, and so I don't really see a point in dressing for someone else's success, because my success is not the same as anyone else's.
While there are many opinions about the new regulations, admin is hoping that these new regulations will stop juvenile student behavior and keep students in their classrooms learning. For Grizzly News Network, I'm Shyla Gonzalez.
Are you still feeling the Grizzly spirit? Well, guess what? The Grizzly Gear Shop has been open for a while, and it's still the place to be. Swing by anytime from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. to stock up on all your favorite accessories. And don't forget to follow them on Instagram at @NHS_Grizzly_gear. Now let's dive into the latest updates from our Grizzly sports.
Weezy out of here. Weezy out of here. Rest a piece of bankroll, showing how to do it. Baby going crazy, even getting straight to it. I done caused him many fights, I ain't no fucking on storage. Catch me in Atlanta, no security with my jewelry. Found out I'm rich, my baby mama talking soon. Another bitch telling lies.
What's up, Grizzlies? Welcome back to another edition of 90 Second Sports. I'm your host, Jackson Cox.
Taylor Webster.
Let's get into it. So, as y'all know, again, took another tough loss to Bryant last week. But, you know, we played, like, as a team, we played better than what we have been the past couple weeks. You know, since Southside have been playing so well. But we really had something that game going, and I think we can build on it this week.
Yeah, I feel like defensively we, you know, improved a lot, and offensively we actually, you know, did some. So I mean, having the start we had, you know, playing Bryant, and you know, going into our next game, you know, I feel like we finna play real decent, you know.
And you know, this week, if y'all don't know, we're playing Little Rock Central, and just like us, they're 0-4. So you know, and it's our homecoming game, so we gotta really lock in and work really hard this game to get a win. And yeah, I think we're going to play good. I think he's going to start something for us and hopefully bounce on to the next couple weeks.
And with that, you know, that's your 90 Second Sports. Hey, Hoco, we finna win.
That's all for today, Grizzlies. Thank you for joining us this morning.
We hope you have an amazing weekend. I'm Riley S.
And I'm Jordan Baker. Catch us next time on GNN.